Hi there. Welcome to today's episode of Survey of Musical Theater. Today, we're going to be talking about theater etiquette. Now, what exactly is theater etiquette, you may ask? Good question. When most people think of theater etiquette, they think of something like this next clip. In simplest terms, theater etiquette is just the way that somebody is expected to behave while they're at the theater. Some people say that it's all about respect for your fellow audience members and the performers. You're having a shared experience, after all. And if all you need is a few rules to make what is and what isn't acceptable a bit clearer, well, so be it. But what are these rules? And where do they come from? How has our interpretation of what's standard theater etiquette changed over time? Is theater etiquette even relevant anymore? Is it elitist or old-fashioned? Well, theater etiquette in itself does date back historically. During the 20th century, theater was not recognized as an event for all types of classes and people. Rather, it was reserved for a certain group called the highbrow audience. That's where the terms theater for polite culture over popular culture became popular. The culture that was allowed in the theater was the wealthy people, the people that dressed very elaborately, wore a lot of makeup, had a lot of money. And this is where the ideas of lower and high sections of theater seats were designed. They were really designed to divide classes rather than the convenience of the theater. In addition to the physical separation of the high box seats and then the lower audience seats, the high class mannerisms and dress and big display of money made a lot of people feel unwelcome in the theater. They felt like they couldn't enjoy it like the highbrow audience could. Therefore, many people felt unwelcome, and the highbrow audience became the main audience of the theater. Some of these traditions that they started stayed in place even when the theater opened up to the general population. But theater etiquette, like anything, changes with time. So while we keep the standard of attire in etiquette, we also have a new one because we're in the 21st century. Technology. But first, let's talk about attire. So, fancy dress expectations that a lot of people have for the theater were rooted in the past with the highbrow audience. On opening night, they would come in fancy dresses and tuxedos, gloves, hats, everything. It would be a huge event, like a premiere. Theater goers would come to the show not only to see the show, but also to be seen, another perk of their high box seats. Even the ushers had a specific dress code. These days, it's a pretty rare occasion if you walk into the theater and someone's wearing tuxedos and ball gowns. Normally, our standard of formal now is what most people would consider church attire. Maybe a dress, a sweater and jeans, slacks, button-ups, but a lot of people go more casual, wearing t-shirts, jeans, shorts. Even open-toed shoes would have been an atrocity decades ago, but now it's a normalcy. But if there is a standard of theater dress attire, normally, people would consider it more of what seems to be a church attire. I like to dress up when I'm going to the theater, but that's my choice. Some people don't, and that's fine. Like I said, it's great that theater has opened up to have a great wider audience and more people can enjoy the art without feeling pressure to dress up or dress down. Now, let's talk about technology. Have you ever wondered what the actors think about people bringing phones into the theater? Well, let's look at this. Lin-Manuel Miranda, the creator of Hamilton, tweeted, "Are illegal photographers tonight. White guy, black cap, 3 rows back, 3 seats in. Older woman, 9 rows back, 7 seats in. We can see you." Another tweet by Casey Levy, who played Elsa in Broadway's Frozen, said, "If you were the young woman about 8 rows back, center orchestra, filming our entire show on your iPhone tonight, please know you completely distracted me and made me almost go up on my lyrics. It's scary when we see people filming us. please stop and just enjoy the dang show. The theater is dark, so one little light that's not on stage, even if it's from something as small as an iPhone, can be really distracting to both the actors and the audience members. Some actors like Kevin Spacey, Benedict Cumberbatch, and Hugh Jackman have all halted their live Broadway performances just to directly address audience members whose phones are interfering with performances. And then there's the classic grand gesture of Miss Patti LuPone, who took matters and cell phones into her own hands during a performance.
We all know how annoying it can be when someone's texting during a show. The actors hate it most of all. So Broadway legend Patti LuPone took matters into her own hands, snatching away the offending phone. ABC's Cecilia Vega has the story.
Hi, everyone.
She is a Tony-winning queen of Broadway.
I know it.
But this morning, Patti LuPone is starring in a new role, cell phone police.
Well, she was texting through the entire first act, and she was sitting right there in the second seat. It was, everybody can see, look how teeny this theater is. And she was oblivious to everybody except for herself and her phone.
The legendary star reenacting the real-life drama on stage last night.
It was right here, it was this lady right here, and I just grabbed the phone and went,
LuPone snatching a phone from an audience member mid-performance on Wednesday.
I feel bad for the people that come here to have a theatrical experience, and it's ruined.
That audience giving LuPone a standing ovation on Twitter. Way to go, Patti. When the lights came back on, an usher returned the phone. But she isn't the only etiquette officer. Watch as last week an audience member at the Broadway show Hand to God hops onto the stage and tries to plug his phone into a fake outlet.
A lot of people to you right now are saying, bravo.
Well, I wish they'd just turn the phone off. I don't want the bravo or the apology.
So if so many people are speaking out against using phones in the theater, including people like Patti LuPone and Hugh Jackman, why is it still a problem? Well, the problem of using cell phones in the theater actually comes down to cell phones in general, and it's a societal issue. During the 21st century, our technology has introduced a pics or it didn't happen complex, proof that we were there, that you have to take a picture or have footage of every single event you attend in order for you to justify that you were there, to prove something to other people. This is where we get the idea of a highlight reel on social media, or having to take selfies or getting odd pictures with celebrities. A few years ago, a cool story would have been like, oh, guess what? I saw Patti LuPone in Times Square. But now that's not enough. You have to have a picture, or better yet, a picture with her. Why is that? Well, like I said, it's a societal issue. We've grown so attached to our phones and having our own virtual world, virtual sphere of influence, and we want the theater to be a part of that too. Theater invites you to be in the moment. But for many people, it's now important also to capture it so you own it forever. People think they're entitled to act as a private broadcast channel for all their friends at home instead of just enjoying an experience in the theater. The fact is, we used to take pictures to capture moments, and now we take pictures to create moments. Of course, cell phone usage in the theater isn't a one-size-fits-all. You're going to have people there who it's their first outing away when they have a new baby, or someone who has a new babysitter, or somebody who just can't be away from work. But even then, common courtesy is to step outside the theater instead of interrupting a performance by looking at your phone. For your own good and for the sake of others, here are some reasons why not to be on your phone at the theater. First, you miss so much of the performance. Looking down at a small 3x5 glass inch screen is nothing compared to looking at the broad stage with a huge set, costumes, musical numbers, dance numbers, everything. Second, being on your phone is a distraction to both the audience and the performers. The noise, the light, the lack of your own presence, other audience members notice it, and performers can see it too. Which brings me to the third point. Being on your phone is rude to the actors. They're getting paid to put on a performance, something they love to do, which you are also paying to see. So doesn't it make sense to give them your full attention just out of common courtesy and respect to both of you? Both attire and technology are two very important aspects of the broad category we label as theater etiquette. But isn't even relevant to call it theater etiquette anymore? The actual word etiquette comes from an old French term that means label, which probably refers to instruction cards used to teach people how to behave properly at the court. It's argued that etiquette is an empty concept. Think about when you go to a very fancy restaurant. Does it really matter which fork you use? I mean, they're all forks. They all have the same purpose. Anyone will do the job. The only reason that etiquette exists is to reinforce social separation. By producing and policing arbitrary rules, you can find out who belongs and who doesn't belong. In one of her many commentaries on the theater, theater critic Kirsty Sedgman says, "What if we just forget the word etiquette and instead ask for good manners and respect?" But how do we rephrase the word respect in universal terms where everyone can agree on what it means, especially in a category like the theater? The word etiquette carries a lot of baggage. So should we stop using it and instead ask for common courtesy and respect? But what does common courtesy look like in the theater? Well, just manners that you'd expect to have anywhere else. Dressing appropriately, not necessarily formally, but you are going out in public and it is a nice performance. Staying off your phone and giving respect to the actors and the audience members around you. Being on time, being punctual, and respecting the time of the performers, the workers, and the audience members. But like any other subject, lines can blur. What about sitting next to someone who has a heavy perfume they usually wear every single day, but you happen to be allergic to it? What about eating during the show, or chewing gum, or smacking gum? What about the classic someone sitting in front of you who's very tall or has a big hairdo or a hat? These are things that are parts of our normal everyday lives that it's hard to complain about or set a strict boundary to in the theater. And that brings us down to the point that going to the theater is going to a public event. There are other people there and everyone has to learn how to get along to enjoy this common performance. People will continue to argue whether or not we need a very strict outline of what theater etiquette looks like. But in the end, it's all about respect for your fellow men and women. You're all there to enjoy the performance. You're all there to be there at the theater and have a great experience. And everybody wants to enjoy it. So let's have respect for each other. Coming down to treating everyone the way you'd like to be treated, behavior in the theater is like behavior with anywhere else. Be aware, be present, and be kind. That's all I have for today. I hope you guys enjoyed this lesson on theater etiquette. See you later.